Quay got up. He said, "What you say, bitch?" This nigga got up like fast as fuck. I was like, "What the fuck wrong with this nigga?" I didn't even know he had these hoes on. So I'm like, shit, if I was to punch this nigga, like, luckily this wasn't no bad day, and then, like, I was just in this hotel, like, if I was to punch this nigga, he could have knocked me out, really caused damage to my jaw and shit. What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, AyImGone, and I'm back at the end of the video, bro. Excuse the low tone. I'm just getting over my sickness and shit, so this is like literally like right after I upload this other video. But excuse my low tone, bro. I will talk too loud, 'cause now I'm fucking gonna start coughing or something. It's going the way I think, but like I said, if y'all want to know what's going on and why I took like 2 weeks off from this shit, it's just go watch the other video and shit. But today is story time. A little rusty, my bad. Bro, this occurred like probably like a month ago. I ain't gonna cap, like a month or two, like a month or 2 weeks ago. This nigga pulled out some brass knuckles on me at the park, bro. Oh, these hoes, the rings. I was like, what the fuck, bro? Keep in mind, the average nigga don't even care about brass knuckles like that. Like, most of you got a knife. This nigga has some black ass brass knuckles. I ain't being fair, and I ain't saying no name. I don't even know any name, so. Long story short, like, we end up going to go hoop. It's gonna be real quick. I ain't gonna make it last that long. So, one day I got out of work and my homeboy asked me to go hoop and shit, which is already off of me. Cause most of the time when I work, I'm either gonna chill with, chill with a girl or, you know, don't say that. Chill with a girl or I'm going to, just trip the crib. I'm not really gonna do too much. I mean, I might work out, like, before I go to work and shit, but most of the time I go to work, like, I be chilling on them days. Most of the time I go out, it be on the weekends, because I don't really like going out that much on the weekday, like, because I know I gotta work or something like that, so it's gonna hold my shit back. Like, today I woke up tired as fuck. I went to work. I came back home at 4 o'clock in the morning. I went to work at 1 p.m. and I had class and shit. I was tired as a bitch. So, I don't really go out. So, this is already something that's atypical for me. Like, what the fuck? This ain't no typical shit I do and shit. So, that's con number one. I get to this hoe. They already hooping. I see other niggas there. I'm thinking this is like a little hoop session. This shit, like, that's con number two. I'm like, damn. There's other niggas here. And then, like, you know, some girls playing volleyball and shit. And then some niggas was playing volleyball with them, too. We started doing that shit later. Which I ain't played. I was low-key. I was pissed off. So, we get to hooping and shit. Like, I played one game. We won one. And then we lost three. Like, when I was on the team, like, we lost three and shit. I was like, man, fuck this. I ain't hooping no more. I don't hoop, so I'm already up. Like, man, fuck this shit. I ain't hooping no more. So, I get to the side. I'm just chilling and shit. I'm like, bro, y'all come rip. They like, bro, y'all come rip the game. Because them niggas was hooping. I ain't gonna lie. Like, they was getting busted so bad that, like, this shit got serious. You know, when niggas start losing, they like, bro, come on, fam, come on. And niggas start, like, balling their fists up and getting mad and shit. Start taking everything personal and shit. Which I don't really know these, like, two niggas I ain't know like that. But, like, I mean, one of the niggas seemed like he was straight. Like, he wasn't even talking that much. But these niggas don't like to lose. Like, they one of them niggas that, like, ain't no serious game. But if they lose, they gonna be tripping and shit. Like, nigga, we don't hoop for real. You don't, bro. These niggas suck at basketball, and they had the audacity to get mad. It always be these high school rejected ass niggas. The niggas that be on C team, they senior year. The niggas that didn't make the team, if you at a public school, you didn't go make the team. Like, some school, they give you a chance, you go play on some bullshit ass little team, you still might not play. These niggas like that. So, long story short, I'm reffing the game and shit, and these niggas hooping hard as fuck. I'm like, damn, these niggas hooping hard as fuck. They're like, man, call these fouls and shit. So I'm like, man, I'm finna help the little team out. These niggas getting busted and shit. They started coming back, right? They was down like, it was a game of 12, so they was down like probably like 8-2 or something like that. Nigga, we helping them out. We making calls to get them back in the game and shit and all that stuff. So, like, keep in mind, but they all hooping as well. Like, they starting to hoop and shit. So they blaming my homeboy, which I'm like, nigga, my homeboy the nicest nigga on the team. Like, not nigga holding nothing, but like, the nigga better than y'all niggas. I'm like, nigga. I was telling them before the game, like, nigga, pick him up. Y'all ain't gonna regret it. So these niggas, like, you know what I'm saying? They start hooping and shit. And I remember, like, in the middle of the game, like, they start coming back. It's 10-11. Keep in mind, they was down like 8-2. This nigga threw the ball in. That hoe went out of bounds. Like, he threw it, like, on the inbound. Nigga threw that hoe in trying to, like, make a, like, a fucking cross-court pass and shit. Nigga, he threw that hoe out. He threw it out of bounds, but he sold them. Like, I ain't gonna lie. He sold the game. I was like, nigga, I'm holding the other ball. I'm like, man, look at that shit. Y'all gonna lose. I said, so I ain't helping y'all no more. Y'all don't want to win. Nigga, I ain't gonna lie. Like, nigga, one of my other homeboys, he's on the team. Nigga, he had did some of that. He did some elite shit with gang. I ain't gonna care. This is, like, for fucking half court as well. So, I'm like, damn. When I see nigga go up, I said, damn, nigga, what is it? Nigga. So, pretty much, like, nigga hit it with, like, in between the legs, then behind the back, into the legs. Yeah. Behind the back, nigga, pulled that hoe from half court, like, leaning forward. Nigga, in that hoe, switch. Like, it ain't nothing but net, you know? So, like I said, y'all niggas really lost this game. But I had to get turned one over. I'm like, that nigga turned up. That nigga put the T on his back. He was hooping that shit. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm congratulating these niggas. And like, this is what I be talking about with niggas, bro. Hold on. This is what I be talking about with niggas, bro. I'm like, ain't no way you niggas just lost the game. I'm like, I'm not trolling or nothing. Like, I don't really know them like that, so I ain't talking shit and shit. See, that shit that pisses me off is when you, like, when niggas talk hard shit to you and what I say, and then you had something to say to me, because now you try to make me like a bitch or something. So, like, now, I'm like, bro, I can't believe y'all niggas lost this shit. I'm low-key trolling, but I'm not trolling super hard. I was just like, man, hell nah, I ain't shaking the loser's hands, y'all niggas. I can't respect y'all niggas after this loss and shit. Like, I ain't shaking y'all hands. But, nigga, I'm talking about strictly the game. I ain't talking about them as a person. Like, nigga, I ain't calling no bitch-ass niggas or nothing. These niggas hoop, they call them bitches. Like, the game's getting the tip. I'm telling you, these niggas were in that shit. Like, they was hooping that shit. So, this nigga had all that seed to walk up on me after I said that shit. And I'm like, nigga, what the fuck was wrong with you, nigga? Like, I don't know him like that. So, I'm like, nigga. I took two steps. I'm like, nigga, what's wrong with you? Then he was like, bro, keep my before you got up. He said, what you say, bitch? This nigga got up, like, fast as fuck. I was like, what's wrong with this nigga? I didn't even know he had these hoes on. So I'm like, shit, if I was to punch this nigga, like, luckily this wasn't no bad day, and then, like, I was just in this whole chilling. Like, if I was to punch this nigga, he could have knocked me out, really caused damage to my jaw and shit. Like, I didn't see him take them hoes off. He, like, what you say, bitch? And he walked up on me, and he was in my face. I said, nigga, what's wrong with you, nigga? I was, like, talking to him and shit. I'm, like, talking, like, a little bit of shit. I ain't saying nothing. I'm like, what's wrong with you now? I'm like, I don't know you like that. What's wrong with you? This nigga walk away, he take them hoes off. So then I got mad. I ain't gonna care. Cause now I'm like, nigga, what if I was to hit you? What was you gonna, hit me with your brass knuckles? That's what I told him. I said, you was gonna hit me with the hoes? I was like, all right, man, let me go to the car and shit. Let me go to the car and shit. But, like, I'm really shocked that this nigga pulled out some brass knuckles on me, though. Like, y'all niggas listen, bro. You young niggas, cause I think he was young and shit, but, bro, I be meaning to teach y'all in these story times. It don't mean to be no no bullshit. It be like, I want y'all to learn, y'all listen. I don't know, bro. You don't know me. But I'll let you know now. Yeah. As I will say, yeah. Nigga. Y'all young niggas, listen. Y'all don't know what people have on them. So don't be dumb and do some stupid shit. Because some niggas don't let shit go. And, like, I let this shit go or whatever, but some niggas don't let shit go, so, like, he could have caused a permanent problem that wasn't that fucking serious. Like, his shit wasn't that serious for him to, like, get up in my face with the brass knuckles. So, I'm like, it just, like, I want y'all to understand, like, if you a young nigga and you, like, doing shit, bro, don't pull out no weapon until you know you gonna have to use it or you defending yourself. I didn't touch this nigga. I didn't push this nigga. I said something wrong to him, quote, unquote, but that's what y'all know. You pull out a weapon, you don't know what type of reaction you're gonna get. So be smart about the shit. And yeah, man, that's it for the story time. I mean, I got a little serious in the end because I was upset about the shit. And I, bro, I ain't gonna lie. If a girl didn't tell me that, hey, listen. If a girl didn't tell me that, bro, man, don't let the shit, bro. Come on now. But. Yeah, man, I hope y'all enjoyed the story time. I'm back, you know what I'm saying? Got some more reactions. I'm finna start doing more vlogs. I'm finna go on a shopping spree soon, bro. I ain't gonna lie. Probably, like, the next, like, month. I'm about to save up. I'm about to go crazy with the saving shit. So I already been saving up, but like I have bills and shit to pay, like low key. So it just kind of be like fucking up my savings, and I got shit to pay for, like my fucking braces and phone and all this other shit. And just they keep popping up. There always be some bullshit that pop up. Like, I ain't gonna lie. Like, I be in the middle of saving. I bow, give me 400 right there. I'm like, damn. That's how saving be though, bro. But yeah, man, I'm back in this thing, bro. It's your boy, I'm gone. I'm out this thing.